हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज ललिता मैम एंड वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल मास्टरमाइंड। इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट चैप्टर 1 क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन एंड मैनेजमेंट। दिस वीडियो इज पार्ट 4 ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। बिफोर यू कंटिन्यू वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो डू सब्सक्राइब टू माई चैनल टू गेट इमीडिएट नोटिफिकेशन। ओके, सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द टॉपिक इरीगेशन। वॉट इज इरीगेशन? What are the two methods of irrigation? Modern methods and traditional methods of irrigation. So, why to delay? Let us peep into today's topic. Now, what is irrigation? Irrigation refers to artificial application of water to the crops for the growth of the plants. Okay, like when you have grown crops and in your area it doesn't rain properly. So, the crops may get spoiled, especially the crops that requires enough water. So, in that case, if it doesn't rain naturally, then at that time you have to provide artificial rain to the crops. And this method of application of artificial rain or artificial application of water to the soil for the growth of crops is known as irrigation. Now, from how can we obtain irrigation? From where do we get this water for artificial application? We get water for this artificial application from wells, lakes, reservoirs and tube wells. Now, from this, how to take water from these water sources and how to reach it or how to give it or provide it to the plants? For that, there are two methods. In olden times, the methods that were involved for irrigation purpose, they were considered as traditional methods. We consider them as traditional methods, the methods that we are following since long. Okay, since long the methods that we are following, they are traditional method. And nowadays the methods that we use, they are modern methods. Okay, so we will explore these traditional methods and modern methods one by one. Now, the different traditional methods are like canal irrigation, furrow irrigation, chain pump irrigation, moat, which is also known as pulley system of irrigation, then Dhekli system of irrigation, Rahat, which is also known as water wheel system. So, these are the different traditional methods of irrigation. Now, what are the advantages or like disadvantages of these methods? We'll explore these methods one by one. But then all these methods, they lead to wastage of water. More amount of water is gets wastage. So that is why the modern methods were evolved from these traditional methods. So we'll explore these traditional methods and modern methods one by one. Okay, now let us try to understand what is canal irrigation. Canal irrigation is nothing but providing water to the field with the help of canals. Now, what are canals? A canal is an artificial channel, okay, that is being constructed. It is a channel or the passage, okay, like through which the water can be passed. Now, how is it constructed? It is constructed by using some materials like concrete, stone, brick, or any sort of material which avoids seepage and erosion. Okay, so if so that the water, it can hold the water in it. Now, this canal or this artificial channel, the function of this artificial channel is to carry water to the fields to perform irrigation purpose. Now, from where the water, like in this channel, from where does the water comes? The water in this channel, it can be drawn out either from the river, tank or reservoirs. From any water bodies, water is being drawn out and it is being passed through the canals. These canals are nothing but these are the artificial channels or passages from where through which the water passes. And these canals, they carry the water from those water bodies to the field. Okay, now in this way, the water requirement of the field gets solved. Now, the next one is furrow irrigation. This irrigation is also known as surface irrigation. This irrigation is very famous throughout the world, and it has been practiced since many years, and it is unchanged. Now, what is surface irrigation? As you can see in this image, on the field, water is being applied, and small like channel like structures are being made across the field. Now, when water is applied, that water gets distributed over the soil with the help of gravity. Gravity, the earth's natural force. Okay. Now, it is the most common method of irrigation which is being used throughout the world, and it has remained unchanged since many years. Now, the next irrigation is chain pump. Now, what is chain pump? In this image, you can observe there is a wheel, like two wheels are there. One wheel is dipped in half or immersed half in the water, and another wheel is, the bigger wheel is at the top in the air. Now, to this wheel, a chain like system is constructed in such a way that the bucket moves and it goes to the water body, and then the bucket is filled, and then that water gets transferred to the passages. Okay, so it consists of two large wheels. Basically, chain pump, it consists of two large wheels. These are connected by chain which doesn't have any end, so this is an endless chain. Then the bottom wheel, like the two wheels are arranged in such a way that one is at the top and the other one is at bottom. So the bottom wheel is half immersed in the water source, and as the wheel is being turned, so the bucket which is connected, it gets dipped in the water bodies or water pool, and then it picks up or it carries the water, and then it is being carried to the top, and from that bucket the water is transferred to the pool again. Okay, like to the passage from where the water has to pass to the field. Then again that empty bucket goes to the water pool, then again it carries the water, and then it transfers. So this process keeps on going, like continuously, till the water requirement is solved. Okay, so this is chain pump. Now, the next traditional method of irrigation is moat, which is also known as pulley system. It is very simplest form of irrigation. In this method, we can say like this is a manual irrigation. You need a manual, or you need a person for this, for performing this irrigation. Now, in this, the water is being drawn out from the well, and then it is that water is poured onto the field with the help of, or it is being passed to the field through the canals. So for this, the well need to be near the field. Yes, so these water bodies need to be near the field, otherwise it is not possible to have this system of irrigation. So this is a manual irrigation, and with the help of pulley, which you can see in the image, the pulley is being fixed to the well, and with the help of the pulley, the water is being taken out. It's as simple as how do you take out water from the well. Okay, and then pour that water in the field with the help of canals. Okay, so now the next one is Dakeley system. Now, what is Dakeley system? Instead of using pulley, it is also done manually, but the person has to make such arrangement, and then person has to take out water from the well with the help of bucket and then pour into the field. But it doesn't have pulley system in it. Okay, so this method also causes lot of wastage of water. Lots of water gets wasted in this system of irrigation. Next one is the Rahat system. In this image, you can observe the two bullocks, or like in for this you require animals, either ox or buffalo or cows, to move or to rotate that wheel. Okay, now this is this was used in olden times. Nowadays it is not being used much. Okay, now in this system there is like these oxen or these buffaloes or cows, these animals, they have to move, and when these animals move, one wheel gets rotated, and then that wheel is connected to the well, with the help of which like from water is being taken out from the well, and that water is passed through one passages, and that passage is connected to the feed. So in this way the water is being carried out. So here the main important thing is to remember that Rahat system is used for irrigation only in olden times. It was used in olden times, and in this it involves animals for moving the wheel. Okay, now the next one is, these were the traditional methods, okay, that the methods that we were following since long. But nowadays modern methods of irrigation have also been evolved by taking into consideration that less water gets wasted. Okay, so the two modern methods of irrigation are sprinkler irrigation and drip irrigation. Now what is sprinkler irrigation and what is drip irrigation? You might have got idea by looking into the image. Yes, sprinkler irrigation, in that which is on the left hand side, you can observe that it's like causing artificial rain, where you have enough water availability, you can have this, you can go for this type of irrigation. But where you have less amount of water availability and you don't want more water to get wasted, and in that places you can use drip irrigation method. So let us explore these, or let us compare the sprinkler irrigation and drip irrigation in the next slide. Now sprinkler irrigation. What is sprinkler irrigation? This method, it involves pumping out water through nozzles. With the help of nozzles, water is being pumped out with the help of motor, pumping motor, and then that water that is being pumped out, it is spread over the field in the form of artificial rain. Okay, now as it, like the places where it is difficult to have, like the places where the land is uneven, so in such places, like if the land is uneven, you cannot go for some other methods of irrigation. So in such places this method is very, very effective. Okay, so this sprinkler irrigation method is effective for the land, for the places where land is uneven, and also the areas that have a sandy soil, where the soil is bit sandy. Now this method involves pumping water through with the help of nozzles and then spraying it in the form of artificial rain. This is about sprinkler irrigation. Now on the other hand, drip irrigation involves use of pipes or tubes, like which has very small holes. You might have seen in the previous image. Let me show you. Yeah, so in this you can see the pipes or the pipe like structures. So these pipe like structures have some holes in them. So this method of irrigation, in this, like where water availability is less or where we have water scarcity, so in that places we can use this method of irrigation, where water comes out from that small hose drop by drop and directly it is being supplied to the base of the plant. So this method is very useful for areas having shortage of water. Okay, so this is about irrigation. Very soon we'll come with the next video for the next topic. Until then, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and share it with maximum people so that they get benefit of this video. Okay, until then, bye bye, take care.